We're watching the making of the legendary Ambur Biryani from scratch. So this is one episode you must watch till the very end. The aroma is subtle, the flavor is subtle, but when you place it in your mouth, all the flavors that's trapped in this biryani sings in harmony to your palate. That's how special the Ambur Biryani is. I'm in Ambur in Tiruppur district in North Tamil Nadu, and I'm here to explore the Ambur Biryani. And not just any Ambur Biryani, but I'm at Rahamaniya, the home of the Ambur Biryani that has a legacy since 1890. So let's go in and check out the Ambur Biryani here at Rahamaniya Briyani Hotel. Let's go. So this is my second visit here. The last visit was over 3 years ago. So I can definitely see that the place has changed. I think it's been renovated. But I'm told that the biryani still remains the same. So let's meet the family that's been tending to the Ambur Biryani since 1890. So I'm with Mr. Rais Ahmed and his son, Faiz Ahmed, who represent the third and fourth generation of the Ambur Biryani tradition. सबसे पहले ये अंबुर बिरयानी का जो ट्रेडिशन है
1890 से जो है हमारे दादा परदादा से है
मुगलाजन के जमाने से है
ओके
मटन बिरयानी
मटन बिरयानी अगर बोले तो माँ को गोश आगो बहुत अच्छा है
ओके
सॉफ्ट रहेगा गोश
यहाँ
का गोश आगो
ओके
गोश बहुत सॉफ्ट रहेगा उसने आपको मटन बिरयानी इधर माँ को फेमस हुआ
फेमस हुआ और यहाँ पे बिरयानी नहीं बिरयानी है
बिरयानी
हाँ क्यों
इधर में सब लोग आपको बिरयानी के लिए बिरयानी बिरयानी बोल के ऐसा आ गया सब लोग
हाँ सो इन अंबुर इट्स द बिरयानी इट्स द बी आर आई नॉट द बी आई आर सो ये स्पेलिंग मिस्टेक नहीं है पहले से वैसे ही है हाँ और आप यहाँ के फोर्थ जनरेशन हो हाँ सो ये जो रेसिपी का जो ट्रेडिशन है वो आपको आपके पिताजी से आया
पिताजी के पिताजी
पिताजी के पिताजी से आया तो वैसे कंटिन्यू हो रहा है ये अंबुर बिरयानी क्यों इतना फेमस हो गया है
उस वाको चावल चावल आपको बहुत सॉफ्ट रहेगा डायरेक्ट सांबर चावल
सो ऑल्सो इन अंबुर दे मेक द बिरयानी विद द जीरा सांबर राइस सो विच इज द स्मॉल ग्रेन द शॉर्ट ग्रेन राइस एंड ही सेज व्हेन यू ईट दैट राइस डाइजेस्ट ईजिली सो यू डोंट रियली हैव एनी ऑफ द साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ईटिंग अ हैवी बिरयानी ही सेज दैट्स व्हाट मेक्स इट एक्सट्रीमली पॉपुलर विच इज व्हाई पीपल लव टू हैव द अंबुर बिरयानी तो ऑफ कोर्स द लास्ट टाइम व्हेन आई केम हियर पहले मैं जब आया था 3 साल पहले वो काफ़ी मतलब 50 ईयर पुराना रेस्टोरेंट लगता था अब जब मैं देखता हूँ कि पूरा रेनोवेट कर दिया आपने हाँ एकदम मॉडर्न लग रहा है सो व्हेन आई केम हियर द लास्ट टाइम अराउंड दिस ईटरी लुक्ड लाइक इट बिलोंग टू द 50s और 60s बट व्हेन आई वॉक इन टुडे इट्स बीन रेनोवेटेड इट्स बीन मॉडर्नाइज इट लुक्स एंड फील्स लाइक इट कुड बी अ रेस्टोरेंट इन एनी मेट्रो ऑफ द कंट्री टुडे सो आपने ये रेस्टोरेंट का लुक तो मॉडर्नाइज किया है लेकिन जो रेसिपी है ट्रेडिशन है वो भी मॉडर्न हो गया है
रेसिपी सब पुराना ही रेसिपी है
पुराना ही है अच्छा वही स्टाइल
वही मास्टर
ग्रेट तो अंदर जाके देख सकते हैं क्या बन रहा है अभी
मटन बिरयानी बन रहा है
लवली सो लेट्स गो इन एंड चेक आउट द मेकिंग ऑफ द मटन बिरयानी हियर एट रहमानिया बिरयानी होटल लेट्स गो ये किचन तो पहले जैसा है वैसा ही है सो ऑल्दो द रेस्टोरेंट इन द फ्रंट हैज बीन रेनोवेटेड द किचन लुक्स एग्जैक्टली द वे इट वाज जमाल भाई कैसे हो
अच्छा
सो आई मेट जमाल द लास्ट टाइम अराउंड व्हेन ही वाज मेकिंग द बिरयानी ही इज अ बिरयानी मास्टर हियर एंड अभी कितना साल 30 साल हो गया आपको यहाँ पे हाँ बिकॉज लास्ट टाइम आई रिमेंबर व्हेन आई मेट हिम तभी 27 ईयर्स हुआ था
27
वेरी गुड So they use the tamarind wood here. So basically what they say is they use the tamarind wood because it also has the flame, the fire that they need for that dum. So that is best in the amli. And the wood also doesn't smoke like the other wood. So we're going to watch the making of the legendary Ambur Biryani here, the mutton biryani right from scratch. So there's some refined groundnut oil that's going in. So Faiz, सीखा है आपने बिरयानी बनाने को?
भी नहीं, अभी training है.
Training है. So now the spices will go into it. Cinnamon along with the elaichi and the cloves. So there's some onion going in, the vengayam. So the onions have just gone in to that hot oil with the spices, and the onions will be now cooked till they're nice and brown. A copious amount of garlic that goes into it. In all that heat and sweat, you can now smell the pungent aromas of the garlic as it's been added to the biryani pot. You know, when you're cooking on a wooden fire, unlike a gas stove or where you can control, regulate the heat quite easily, this requires a lot of skill and a lot of effort. You need to make sure that you have the constant temperature that's being maintained. So therefore, you need to make sure that there is a flame that's always kissing that biryani pot. And that's a difficult task when you're cooking something over a wood-fired stove. The onions are beginning to caramelize there. They're beginning to turn a light, toasty brown. And some ginger that just went into the biryani pot here. So he's basically going to cook the spices, onions, and the ginger and garlic paste till it becomes a light, toasty brown before he adds in the other ingredients that go into the making of the Ambur Biryani. Takali.
Takali.
The tomatoes. Ye kya pudina?
Pudina.
Kotmir pudina. So there's a mix of coriander and mint. You can now recognize the Ambur Biryani taking shape. I mean, that's typically the color of the finished Ambur Biryani. Once the tomatoes goes in, it imparts that light brownish orange tint, and that's typical of the Ambur Biryani, which is very faint, very subtle in its color. So that's the chili that's going into the biryani, and this I'm told is the Kashmiri chili. So it's got that beautiful orangish red color. So these are the chilies that go into the Ambur Biryani. Ye Kashmiri chili hai. So ye ki use karte hai isko?
Ye dada ji isme color khar sab kam raha hai, khar sab raha hai.
Ah, so he says that the spices in this is much lesser, but it imparts a nice color. So you can already see that biryani mix there is now a seductive orangish red in its color. So all the color in the Ambur Biryani comes from the ingredients that go in. कुछ कलर नहीं यूज करते हो?
थोड़ा सा, क्या भी कलर से क्या मिलेगा?
सो इन द अंबुर बिरयानी देयर इज नो आर्टिफिशियल कलर, नो एडिशनल कलर दैट्स यूज्ड. द कलर ऑफ द बिरयानी कम्स फ्रॉम द कलर्स ऑफ द इंग्रेडिएंट्स दैट गो इनटू इट, नेमली द टोमेटो एंड द कश्मीरी चिल्ली. तो ये जो कर्ड का
गर्ड,
हां, तो ये आप सेट करते हो?
हम बनाते हैं. साइकिल का दूध लेकर, गाय का दूध को लेकर गर्म करके उसमें दही डाल के बनाते हैं.
पैकेट का नहीं. सो इवन द कर्ड दैट्स मेड हियर इज द कर्ड दैट दे सेट इन नाउ. सो दे बाय द मिल्क एंड दे मेक द कर्ड, दे सेट द कर्ड एंड दैट्स द कर्ड दैट इज यूज्ड. सो बेसिकली द मीट कम्स फ्रॉम द मेल गोट, दे कॉल इट द पोटला मटन हियर, एंड द गोट इज नो मोर देन 10 किलोस. सो दैट वे यू एंश्योर वो मीट एकदम गल जाता है. सो द मीट देन इज सॉफ्ट एंड इज नॉट च्यूई. सो दैट्स द रीजन व्हाई दे एंश्योर दैट द गोट इज ऑलवेज लेस देन 10 किलोस. The potla mutton. Now the akni is ready to meet the meat. Oh, there's also a good amount of the fat that's gone in, which also will impart its flavor. So that meat is getting integrated into that akni, and they basically use a complete animal. Of course, there's no kidney, there's no heart, or there's no offal or organ meat that goes into the biryani here. Eyes are red from the smoke of the tamarind wood. We've spent the last 30 minutes here watching the akni, the mutton being cooked. So the jeera sambar rice is now going to be boiled. So So the rice is washed and then soaked for about half an hour before it is added to the boiling water. अभी कितना टाइम ये कुक होएगा ये राइस?
10 मिनट.
Some salt that goes in. वो उसमें नमक नहीं डाला?
डाला.
So they basically wait for the rice to be cooked nearly halfway through before they add the rice to the meat. So there's some lemon juice that's going into the akhni for some acidity, I'm told.
Half boiled.
Half boiled. So this half boiled rice is now being strained into the cloth before it can finally make its journey and meet the akhni that's been cooking to make the famous Ambur Biryani. So that half cooked rice is now found its way finally to the meat to make that famous Ambur Biryani. So there's 15 kilos of meat and 15 kilos of rice. So the meat is already in smaller pieces, so he wants to make sure he doesn't break it up further. So very skillfully he mixes the rice into the akhni here. Okay, abhi dam. The cooking of the biryani here has now entered its final stage, which is the dam. As you can see, he's taking all the wood embers, collecting them, gathering it around that biryani deg, around the biryani pot, and even on top of the biryani vessel. This is the final cooking stage of the Ambur Biryani. It has become so hot, I can feel my skin singe. It's as hot as that. The biryani, of course, is delicious, but the effort, the pain that goes, the toil that goes into making this Ambur Biryani is incredible. So the biryani has begun its final journey towards the plate here, and this is the process of dam. So as you can see, all the heat has been removed from the bottom of that biryani pot, the biryani deg. And you've got all the heat that's now on top of the biryani deg and also surrounding it. This is the final process of dam. So the biryani will now take about 25 minutes to be finished before we can finally taste the legendary Ambur Biryani here at Rahamania Briyani Hotel. I love the golden color of that Ambur Biryani. Ready?
Ready ho gaya.
Oh lovely. So I got the Ambur Biryani that's as fresh as that. Abhi taste karoge? To kya dekhte ho aap biryani mein? Kaisa bana hai ki nahi? Kya hona chahiye?
Isme dam ho gaya dekhna rice.
Haan.
Dam ho gaya dekhna taste.
The rice is hot. मेरा मानना है कि सबसे पहले राइस टेस्ट करना चाहिए. हाँ तो राइस में फ्लेवर होना चाहिए. द राइस है दैट स्मोकी अरोमा. हाँ वो दम का. ये जो राइस है एक एक दाना अलग है लेकिन हर एक दाने में वो बिरयानी का फ्लेवर है. एज ही मिक्सेस द अखनी इनटू दैट राइस एंड एज द राइस इज कुक्ड अलॉन्ग विद द अखनी एंड देन ऑन दम that akhni has impregnated every grain of the rice with its flavor. Oh, this is delicious. Bahut badhiya hai. Bahut badhiya hai. I can't wait to taste more of the rice. I always believe that the flavor of a good biryani you will find in the rice. Can't wait to taste this piece of meat. This is hot. I love the fat. I love that sheath of fat that's wrapping the meat. That meat is soft, flavorful, and you can taste the juiciness of the meat. This is a delicious Ambur Biryani. A1 Jamal. Very good. Of course, this is a recipe that's passed on from generations. So he's a third generation, so his grandfather gave it to his father. His father gave it to him. And now, of course, his son is learning how to make it. And of course, they have the team here, represented by the biryani masters like Jamal, who are helping them carry forward that culinary legacy, that culinary tradition. Reading the biryani, but we're in Tamil Nadu and therefore the banana leaf. I've already tasted the biryani in there, but I'm looking forward to tasting that moist, freshly made mutton biryani off the banana leaf here at Rahamania.
Mutton biryani, Naatu Kozhi biryani.
Naatu Kozhi biryani, oh. So of course we've got a biryanis here. I'm trying to make an effort to say the biryani because everywhere else is a biryani, but here it's a biryani. This is the mutton biryani that we saw being prepared. I got a bit of a taste of the biryani as it was just taken off the dum, but I'm waiting to spend some more time with it. Spend time with this biryani at leisure. And what's also been a happy bonus is that today is a Wednesday. And every Wednesday they make also the Ambur Biryani, but with a Naatu Kozhi or the country chicken. So I can't wait to taste this too. I've never tasted an Ambur Biryani with the Naatu Kozhi. And of course, the Vanjaram here, the sear fish fry came highly recommended, as also the chicken leg piece. And there is some salan here, the eggplant salan, and some pachdi with the onions and cucumber. I want to begin with the biryani, but I think if I begin with the biryani, I'll probably lose myself in them. I think I'm going to taste a bit of the vanjaram before I get to the biryani. So this is a sear fish, as you can see, it's doused with a generous lashing of that masala. You definitely taste a lot of the fenugreek that's gone into the masala. That's something that you taste right away. This fish would benefit from a touch of the lime. Take the fish and also get one of these roasted curry leaves on it. That curry leaf takes the fish in a whole new dimension, as does the acidity of that lime. I like the fact that the skin in this fish has been fried to a crisp. Before we move to the biryani, the leg piece or the chicken leg piece. This is a marinated, deep-fried leg of chicken. The chicken is fried to a near crisp. The chicken is fried to the perfect crisp outside and yet retains its moistness, is juicy on the inside. With the crisp curry leaf. Yeah, whenever you see curry leaf on a dish, you're not meant to separate the curry leaf from the dish. You're supposed to relish the toasty herbaceousness of the curry leaf with that dish. We'll get back to the chicken and the fish, but we are here for the biryani, and that's what we're going to go for next. The rice is nice and warm. So when you're tasting an Ambur biryani here at Rahamania, you typically find small pieces of the meat, and there are quite a few of those pieces. So for example, here I've got already three on my banana leaf, and I think there are still three or four still remaining in my plate. So what that allows you is to taste the meat along with every morsel of the rice, which is what you want to do when you're tasting a mutton biryani. Always go for the rice first. This biryani has come off the deg not more than 15 or 20 minutes ago. The rice is still warm and moist to the touch. You know, the Ambur biryani is a biryani that's very mellow. That's mellow in its aromas, that's mellow in its flavors. It's as subtle as that. It's not a biryani that you will smell from a mile away, but it's a biryani that draws you in with its subtle aroma. Also the flavor of the akhni that's impregnated every grain of the rice. I haven't tasted the meat yet, as you can see, but I can taste all the flavors of that meat in the rice here.
Every grain of the rice is separate, having swollen up to absorb that delicious moist flavor of the akhni. Time to taste the meat. The meat is mellow in its flavors. I want to taste some of that meat now with the rice. The meat is moist, yet looks a little dry on the outside, but when you bite into it, it's soft and juicy. It's lent all its juices to the rice because you taste the flavor of the meat in the rice. I'm going to get some more of the rice onto my plate. Then when we were watching the biryani being cooked, we saw a bunch of ingredients that went into it. The spices, the onions, the tomato, the garlic paste. But when you look at this biryani, you can't see any of the ingredients that have gone into it. So all the ingredients that have gone into it to make for the akhni have dissolved completely whilst the biryani was being cooked. So you don't spot any of the ingredients that went into the making of this biryani. And all that akhni finds its way into the flavor of the rice. When made well, the Ambur Biryani is probably the most delicate of biryanis that you can taste. The aroma is subtle, the flavor is subtle, but when you place it in your mouth, all the flavors that's trapped in this biryani sinks in harmony to your palate. That's how special the Ambur Biryani is. I still have the Naatu Kozhi biryani to taste, but I can't seem to let go of the flavors of this biryani. Let's taste it now with that baigan salan. You can definitely taste the heat of the pepper and the tartness, the acidity of the tamarind that's gone into the salan. So if you like your biryani a little spirited, I think you can take some of the salan and mix that into your rice to make for a slightly spicy mouthful, especially with that peppercorn. But if you ask me, I love the flavors of the Ambur Biryani just by itself. Just that rice along with a tiny piece of the meat. I love the bits of fat that's still clinging onto the meat, which gives it all that flavor. You can't waste any of that because that's really where all the flavor of this biryani is trapped. You want to get every bit of that flesh, every bit of that meat off the bone. The flavors of this biryani are as precious as that. I think time now to taste the Naatu Kozhi biryani. I'm told this is prepared in exactly the same fashion that the mutton biryani is prepared in. You want a generous piece of the leg. As you can see, this is the Naatu Kozhi and therefore the pink flesh. This is not the broiler chicken, this is the Naatu Kozhi, the country chicken. And I'm told that this biryani takes more time to prepare as compared to the mutton biryani because of the strength of the meat. Take some of the rice. I think what's different here is that, you know, there's some flecks of the tomato that I can see in this that I did not see in the mutton biryani. Perhaps these flecks were trapped in the Naatu Kozhi bones as the biryani was being cooked. I can definitely see, I mean, although the masala is the same, I can definitely see a slight difference in the color of the biryani. This seems to be slightly deeper as opposed to the chicken biryani. So the flavor of the rice of the Naatu Kozhi biryani is very similar to the flavor of the rice in the mutton biryani, except for the fact that you probably miss a tad bit of the fat that you also tasted in the mutton biryani. I guess chicken is a much leaner meat as compared to mutton, and that makes a difference when it comes to the flavor that comes from the fat. Other than that, this is a tasty biryani as well. I'm going to taste some of the meat. This meat, of course, is a lot tougher than mutton biryani. It has more of a bite too. can see the pink color of the Naatu Kozhi, the country chicken. That chicken is flavorful. I'm going to chase it now with that rice. If you love your Naatu Kozhi, if you want to taste your country chicken and you like your biryani too, definitely try the Naatu Kozhi Ambur Biryani here. But as for me, I love that mutton biryani here. And that's what I've come here for. Enough meat, time to get some fiber in, get some of this pachadi with the rice. The flavor of that rice that's cooked in that mutton akhni. You really need nothing else. You don't even need the meat. That's how flavorful this rice is. This is a biryani that's subtle in every aspect. It's subtle in its aromas, it's subtle in its flavors, and it certainly is subtle in the gentle warmth that envelopes your throat as you near the end of your mutton biryani here at Rahamania Briyani Hotel in Ambur. Rahamania Briyani Hotel in Ambur is a rare culinary enterprise. You have four generations of a family that's committed to preserving a certain culinary tradition over 130 years. Times have changed and even the eatery has changed in a lot of ways. But what has not changed is their commitment and dedication to preserving a culinary practice, to preserving a culinary tradition in the form of that very special Ambur Biryani. Ambur is halfway between Chennai and Bengaluru. So if you're looking for an excuse to drive out, you can't find a better excuse than this. Drive into Ambur, look for Rahamania Briyani Hotel and savor a taste of a 130-year-old culinary tradition. As for me, I'm going to go back to that delicious biryani rice. Until the next episode of Gourmet On The Road, stay safe and happy eating.
At Food Lovers TV, my team and I work hard to produce engaging food and travel videos. If you like our work, do check out our Patreon page where you can pledge a nominal sum in lieu of special privileges like behind the scenes footage, early video release, exclusive Q&As, merch and much more. For more info, check out the link in the description below. Also, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to subscribe, share, like and leave a comment here. Happy eating!